Hey guys, I'm just getting ready for a little trip out to Juan De Fuca. I think we're gonna do 3 days, 2 nights. It's a Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. Should be interesting. I think we're gonna get like 10, 15 millimeters rain on Sunday, about 5 on Monday, and it might actually be kind of nice on our way out on Tuesday. So that's kind of nice. So I'm just gonna get getting some stuff ready here, getting food. There's gonna be three of us. Getting some things organized, and what I'm working on right now, most important, coffee, of course, some hot chocolates, nice drinks. Yeah, should be a fun time.
But my love, by the gasworks wall, dream the dream by the old canal. I kiss my girl by the factory wall, dirty old town, dirty old town. Clouds are drifting across the moon. Cats are prowling on their beat. Spring's a girl from the streets at night. Dirty old town, dirty old town.
They're great for dry weather.
Sounds a tight one.
Yeah, dude, I might have cut it really, I kind of cut it at a sharp angle back. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, it's so close. Or not. It's cracking. You can hear it cracking down there. There you go.
I'll be able to chop it after that point. Anyways. Oh yeah, you split. Side wedge.
Side wedge.
That sound, so good. Satisfaction.
Jesus.
Are you going down there?
Yeah.
Are you? Yeah, I want you to grab me. We need to go and see, you know your coat pocket? You know the inside coat pocket?
Yeah.
Can you grab me what's in there, please?
Nice.
He's like, oh, are you brushing your teeth? You put your teeth back in? That's gross. I'm like, yeah, and while you're down there, can you grab something out of your pocket for me?
Sure.
And I just know it's gonna, like, I know how it's gonna happen, too. It's so predictable. I take my Nalgene everywhere with me too, Aubrey. I never had a water bottle and I always bring my biohazard one, my glow in the dark one.
I always have one full of water for like next to my bed, like the ceiling or whatever. Thank you.
bacon dipper.
Bacon dipper.
Thank you.
Thank you.
He looks like he's got webbed feet. That's...
Where is he?
Uh-oh.
Where are you headed, man?
Yeah, man, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, this one was pretty great for me. Thank you, though.
Open up the staff.
Oh. You think it's like the water's up to about here? It needs to be like most of the. I don't see breakfast.
Can you hold this for 1 second?
Yeah. Oh shit, right. Sorry about that. Oh, wouldn't go back. So nice.
Do you mind if I just kind of modify this a little bit?
Of course.
What I have?
Oh,
needed a little bit of work.
Usually just leave it right on top of my my either like just somewhere very handy.
Oh, I put everything inside my
suitcase. Oh, do you?
My clothing, my everything. I put like this. I have this all inside my sleeping bag. Everything.
At night?
No, during the day. Like all day, everything will be inside my sleeping bag.
So and why not?
It's kind of dry and warm. And yeah. It's not all damp and gross. And then I bring it all out. That's how I do it.
That's a good way. I at night it always goes under my head. I've got that sort of a stuff sack, like the pillow. It's a pillow stuff sack.
I gotta figure out something better.
Oh, yeah, that's fancy.
And I also have my inflatable pillow, so I have two pillows out there.
And then, I do that trick that you taught me, which all my Gore-Tex is on my side, lining my side.
Yeah, I like doing that, definitely. Keeps everything. Keeps your head and your feet dry, I think. Hey, my big Elvis.
Dad's just adjusting my carpet a little bit. Great.
What's the first slice?
Oh, awesome.
Hey, Dad.
Oh, there's what Corey can get.
There we go.
Where did McAnaren, staying with the bear camp?
What was that platform? It was different configuration back then. They never had these. That was sort of, if I remember correctly, like this is when we went.
Well, there used to be two platforms over there.
What, is that right?
There used to be one right across from another.
Okay.
And we came 1 year and it was all torn down. It was almost like, I think the ocean had pretty much washed it away.
Reclaimed it. I remember, well, so when I first came down here, though, you came down the path, and right there was a farmhouse with goats.
Really?
Like, people lived there. They've been squatting there for years and years and years. They had all these little kids, and I don't recall necessarily them being who I saw, but, you know, there's people out surfing all the time, and their kids were massive surfers, like, became... I don't know, world champions, but like really big time surfers. They got booted out of here. They lived here for 20 some odd years, I think. And two of their sons died like within 3 months after leaving here. One died, his truck went off a pier up in Port Renfrew. He drowned. And the other one, I think, died on a car accident on this road. I remember seeing the old dude. He had a big school bus up top there, and I see him with his wheelbarrow with propane tanks going up there, and he just looked like a zombie. It was weird.
Well, Mom said that she met one of them down at one of the beaches.
Yes, we did. We were weekend at Sombrio here, and she came back to camp on the beach just to remember it. She wanted to, you know, this. She grew up here, she said.
was she like, hippie?
You know what, you know me. I stood off in the distance when the conversations took place.
I know you. I'm like you.
She wasn't really cute.
That's nice stuff.
Well, he's an honest man.
I was honest. I didn't want to invest a lot of time here. All the stuff when I get home.
Oh yeah. Big time, hey?
It's gonna be a drying machine down here.
We need another propane, so.
I'll dry mine out, get ready for you guys tomorrow.
Oh, I was just gonna ask, you may have some big
arriving.
Yeah. High fives.
My little tarp weighs 7 pounds.
Yeah, this is just a well-built path. I don't blame you for not wanting to abandon it. Jesus. It's a unit, hey? It's huge. How many liters is this?
I think it could hold up to about 118.
Whoa, with the head, with the frame?
Yeah.
That's awesome. Jesus.
I've filled it many times.
Like, I thought the Zenith was big. It's 88.
Oh, is that right?
That's lots of space.
Problem is, you have to load it up.
Yeah. You just gotta get the light here.
Yeah, that's it. I gotta start investing some money into this hobby of mine. When you take into consideration your tank, your pack, your gear, your stove, your food, like, you must be probably hiking with about $1,000 worth of gear, $4,000 worth of gear.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. Your Gore-Tex, your fucking...
Just so you get that upper hand of Mother Nature.
Pretty great yesterday in the rain too.
Yeah, it was
didn't destroy you.
No, it's nice when you're not getting, wet.
Yeah.
But then it just dries so fast.
Yeah, totally.
You know, when you get, if you get a little break in from Mother Nature, it doesn't take long to be right back in the game again.
No, those. Arc'teryx tops, just like, yeah, the jackets, they're dry so fast.
Yeah,
if I had my Fall Raven Gore-Tex pants, though, they wouldn't have dried out as fast.
Probably not. They're a little thicker, right?
Yeah.
Material?
It's like a soft Gore-Tex that's thick and, yeah.
And then I have socks up to here. Those socks that I bought, I wear them all the time. Those.
I was trying to figure out what you were wearing last night.
Look at, no, these ones, see? As soon as the winter hits, this is all I wear. It's my fault.
Yeah. Oh.
What are you trying to figure out what I was wearing last night?
The big.
Those are the woolies from, those are the woolies from Gabe. Remember I brought a brown pair and a gray pair, and you're like, do you really need two pairs?
Is that what I said? Oh, bad.
Any ever roll left? Okay?
Yeah, you want? Yeah. Please.
Yeah.
I wasn't going to say it, because I'm a nice person. But it's really handy. Oh, I got a hole in it. Ah!
What from?
I'm going to have to put my cool shit on it that I got at home. Patch kit.
Tech tape.
Hey, that's cool.
That tech tape is so cool, hey? I'm like so impressed with that tech tape, Dad.
Yeah. Like, look at my tent. Like, you should look at the, like, you think, man, it's got to be wet in there. The floor?
Looks like it, no?
No. Say like Darth Vader. Impressive.
I think it's cool if I say it around you guys, but if I say it around everybody else, you know, they're gonna be like,
okay.
It's cool. What the fuck?
Fair enough.
It's weird. It's kind of weird.
My phone's not working, man.
Phone's not working? Is it dead?
I don't know. When I went to bed last night, I had to do something.
Charge it back. You know what it could be? It could be cold and damp from. Oh, it's on. Oh, it's 0%.
0%. Oh. I wonder what happened.
It could be just cold and it's an older phone.
Is that a bit long?
Really? That would have been pretty epic.
here, my friend.
Look at the steamers, it's boiling, man. Look at the steamers.
This is compared to your tent, how light my tent is.
Is that all of it?
That's my tent. That's not the fly with the tent. Like
so,
this your pig.
Do you know how the bottom of our tent was very damp when we were on Cape Cod? Like it felt damp. This doesn't feel damp at all.
Doesn't understand. Ours could be internal condensation from our body heat rather than leakage.
Reflexes failed me.
All I saw was your tent come flying out past this.
I kind of tossed it up in the air gingerly to catch it. It was like, too far. It's like a big wet sausage. Look at, yeah, it is. It's like it's in a sausage casing.
How light is that? Is that?
Oh, well, it's really wet.
That's both.
Oh yeah, that's it. Right, I'm sure.
And you put that in a compression sack?
Nope.
You can probably just
I separate it usually. Right now I don't give a shit because we're going on. But I usually put the fly in my top pouch and then the other part inside. On the inside.
It's so thin you could just like stuff it in a pocket so easily.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. I gotta put it in a fanny pack. Probably could fit in a fanny pack. There's that one that's like, what is it? 3.8 meters or something. Pretty good size one. It's like $120. I love that fanny pack.
You love that fanny pack?
Yeah. It's a cool fanny pack. Really a cool fanny pack from Malcolm Clark. It's got, it opens up, it's got some pouches. It's like, it's a big fanny pack. Cool fanny pack. My other fanny pack, which I've had for years, has a little water bottle holder and a little hose holster. It's all falling apart.
Isn't that the one that you used to be able to buy pieces for?
Yeah, you could.
It's too bad they got rid of it.
of surfers out, eh?
Fun night last night.
I feel like we got pretty spoiled.
We did.
It was a great game.
Do you guys want me to leave recording or I can take it?
Tuck in here and put it like right there or right here. Fuck it, I ain't splitting on that much work tonight. If it rains, I'm coming back here and putting on the solo stove.
I thought the forecast there was supposed to
be. Perfect.
You're not good enough to do with your father.
Well,
that's
not
weird anyway.
Not yesterday.
I did a little bit that night day with Corey Douglas, but just a tiny bit. And I don't even know what really much to do. I'm not really looking for it. I wouldn't really want to do it. Last time I did it, I was 35 years ago.
Yeah, last time I did it,
I didn't have a good experience. I've had a few bad ones with mushrooms.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, well. Yeah, Kayla was talking to me, I guess there's different, like, I yelled at you last night about the strains, how you can get, like, the different strains,
yeah.
Like a strain
yeah.
of 9 or a strain of 10, and it's a triple A, like, I don't understand it, right? Like, I don't get it. And she was telling me that she hasn't been liking my stars stuff lately.
Okay.
Because she says she's not getting her...
Baked.
And she says weird. That's what she said to me the other day, and I thought you'd find this interesting. She's like, it's really weird. Great. Absolutely great stuff. She said, I bought an ounce, and I got this ounce in, and she goes, I don't even know how to explain it. It's like it wasn't even getting the bait. But what I was saying is, you know how all that weird shit's going on with your meat?
Yeah.
You're getting it delivered?
Yeah.
So she's like, I don't know. She's like, it's just not touching. She's like, I would like to know what strain it is. She's like, I don't know, maybe it's like a strain 5 or something. And I think I'm eating like, you know, maybe like a strain higher, like a strain 11 or a strain 13. And I'm like, yeah, and if that doesn't work, you can go to crystal meth.
Well, that's the thing, you know, yeah, you can buy higher, you can could buy the 180 stuff or the 120 ounce. I just want the 120. I don't care. I don't need to be.
But I think Kayla's done, I would say, a bit of a.
Oh, shit.
I think Kayla's probably. Kayla can't say no.
What's that?
Kayla can't say no. It's like a garbage bin.
You leave that wood now.
Yeah, that's staying. That's staying.
That'll be an express for me. Thank you. How much was it? We can give you money for that.
For what? I'm not giving money.
One
for
day
that.
I will come to you and I will ask you for a favor. You cannot say no to this favor. I saw that in a movie once.
I always wanted to say it.
I always wanted to say it. Why did I do that? Get back up. Oops.
Weird.
Like the umbrella.
Yeah. You know what? The real reason I had it back was for Buddy. I've done it before where I bring Buddy out and I'll put him underneath the umbrella while I'm doing shit.
He stays
under.
Oh, that's smart.
Yes and no. He's getting smarter, so he might. You know, he probably would just stay under now, I think.
You know that Beast guy, the blue Beast guy from X-Men?
Yeah.
And he's like in the library from the professor. It's Buddy.
He couldn't come, he was crying.
Yeah, he was totally ready to run out the door when we left. He actually kind of leaped out the door. It was sort of sketchy.
I felt bad too, though.
But can you imagine last night with the fireworks?
It would have been nice during the night. Like, it would have been fun in the tent with him.
And that's if he wasn't freezing fucking cold. Actually, I don't think he would have been from the fire.
No, he wouldn't have been last night. He would have been right under in my sleep bag. He doesn't get cold. He gets warm and I get uncomfortable.
Yeah.
But I love it. I'm awake anyway, so why not?
Yeah, we were at Lizard Lake. T-Li had like all of these very beanie meals. And
what were they? Beanie meals?
Like beans, like wild rice and beans and chili and anyways, in the morning, like, the tent, I think, honest to God, that one stands out. Like, that is the worst night I've ever
had. That was a rough night.
That was bad.
Rough night? You just slept through it. Anyway, so, and every time I'd have to, when I woke up and went to the bathroom, I'd have to get my sleeping bag, Dad, and I'd actually have to do up the whole hood, and then I'd have to face my face into the sleeping bag with my buff over my face.
It wasn't that bad. It wasn't
that bad. Anyways, in the morning, I wake up, and I looked over at T-Line, I'm like, I'm getting out, I gotta go to the bathroom, don't move, like, you're not allowed to move. All of a sudden, I see a sleeping bag move, and Kevin sticks his head out, and I'm like, help, help. How are you doing, Pat?
50 long stockings.
It's the mech meals, they really get me. I don't know why. Something about the, like, astronaut beat. It was so good, though. That path to Primavera was great.
Because I think your body's used to, like, a whole childhood and lifetime of organic.
Yeah. No, I mean,
and then you eat that, and your body's just like, whoa. What the fuck?
What are you?
So much protein, but.
What are you? What are you?
Titanium sports.
Oh,
and they're about, but they're only about that long.
Okay.
And I know how you like the really.
Dude,
I had three of them picked out. I had one for you, one for mom, one for T, and then I was like, ah.
They're cool. And like when you cut the mech meal in half, like you've been doing, like you cut the top, it makes it easier. But it's nice to have the long handle.
I think it's going to rain on you today.
You think it is?
Beautiful, isn't
it? It's pretty gray.
Thank you.
She never would betray me. The devil take the women, for they never can be his.
Mushroom durunda. What fall the daddy o? What fall the daddy o? There's whiskey in the jar.
I went up to my chamber, all for to take a slumber. I dreamt of gold and jewels, boys, and sure it was no wonder. But Jenny took my charges, and she filled them up with water. Then sent for Captain Farrell to be ready for the slaughter.
Mushroom durunda. What fall the daddy o? What fall the daddy o? There's whiskey in the jar.
I'd like to find my brother, he's the one that's in the army. I don't know where he's stationed, is it Cork or in Killarney? Together we'll go riding o'er the mountains of Kilkenny. Oh, I know he'll treat me better than my darling sporting Jenny.
Mushroom durunda, what fall the daddy-o? What fall the daddy-o? There's whiskey in the jar.
Yeah. Nice.
if I rock upon the waves, no coast to lie. Only coming up threes, boys, coming up threes, boys. Let them go down in the mud where the rivers are untried. If I shall fall from grace of God, where no doctor can relieve me, if I'm buried beneath the sod, still the angels won't receive me. Let me go, boys, let me go.